In some cases, I think the media and fans are pretty unfair as to labeling players as a bust too soon, and that's what we're going to talk about in today's video. What happened to Michael Colle of the New York Islanders, and is he a draft bust, and did we give up on this guy too soon? Coming into the 2014 NHL draft, Michael Colle was a consensus top 5 pick, and some people even thought that he could jump into the top 3 as he led the Oshawa Generals with 95 points, 39 goals during the regular season, and adding 8 goals and 20 points in 12 games of playoffs. The next season, Colle finished with his best year in junior with 42 goals and 93 points in 56 games, and he led Oshawa to a Memorial Cup with 31 points in 21 games. He was also tied for the team lead in points during the Memorial Cup final. Oshawa had a dominant team this year, finishing first in the OHL, and they beat some very good teams, but it was often Cole Castles and Anthony Cirelli who was tasked with shutting down the opposing team's top center lines during the playoffs, including guys like McDavid and DeBrincat, Dreisaitl, Duclair and Ernie, Perlini and Hosang, while Colle and Michael McCarron were given easier defensive assignments, and Colle was named to the Memorial Cup All-Star Game, but Dreisaitl was easily the MVP of the entire tournament. The start of the 2015 season was a setback for Michael Colle. He started slowly after Oshawa had nowhere near the team it did in years prior, as well as having a nagging groin injury, but it was a relatively early cut at Canada's World Junior Championships, with his defense being the main concern. Shortly after Colle was cut, he was traded to Kingston in a massive trade, thought to solidify Kingston as a major contender for the OHL Championship and even the Memorial Cup. Colle vastly improved his play from the start of the season, scoring 27 goals and 55 points in 30 games with Kingston to take the number one seed in the conference, but they would go on to be swept by Niagara in the second round, although Colle still managed 18 points in the 9 games. Following Kingston's elimination, Colle was sent to Bridgeport to finish the season, but he nor the rest of the Sound Tigers really could do much, and it wasn't really a standout performance for him in the American Hockey League whatsoever. In the beginning of the 2016-17 season, Colle was supposed to take the next step. Other top picks from the draft had begun to make their mark on the NHL, and Colle was expected to follow. He didn't disappoint, but 15 goals and 41 points over 75 games in the American Hockey League wasn't that impressive for a top 5 pick either. And other players who were called up ahead of Colle, like Josh Hosang, he got to start, Steve Bernier got his last kick at the can, even Connor Jones got a short call-up, and Colle went into the offseason needing to improve, but he really didn't. Colle was assigned to Bridgeport on September 26th, getting cut from training camp almost a full 2 weeks before the regular season, and that's an awful start for any player, let alone a top 5 pick. About a month later, Colle started getting scratched in the American Hockey League, and the bust label started getting thrown around, and that is really where we find ourselves today. He's played in a couple NHL games up to this point with not really any stats to show for, not even a minus, not even a plus, and it was just to kind of give him a taste. And now with John Tavares being on the outs, is he going to get an opportunity to play in the big leagues next season? In my opinion, I don't really label anyone as a bust until they are out of the organization or have failed at the NHL level, and I don't think Colle really has showed us enough that he's incapable of playing at an NHL level, and with the way the New York Islanders organization is going, I think he's going to get all the opportunity in the world to make the team next season. He's only 22 years old, and the question of this video really is, did we give up on Michael Colle too soon, and is he a bust? I don't think so just yet. I would say we're going to know the answer to this question at the end of next season. I do think maybe some people have given up on him too soon because he's still in the Islanders organization and he's still 22 years old with a lot to prove, and I think a good summer, a good training camp, we could see this guy on the New York Islanders roster come opening night. So now, this is where you guys come in. I want you to let me know down in the comments section, did we give up on this guy too soon, and is he a draft bust? Does he have any type of future in the NHL? If there's any other players you want to see this style of video made on, make sure to let me know down in the comments section. They don't have to be a top 5 pick, they can pretty much be anywhere throughout the first round that had high expectations. So with that being said, I really hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure to drop a like on it and subscribe to the channel for daily NHL content, and I'll see you guys all in the next video.